Jesus' name. In the name of Jesus. The Spirit of God is in this place. And today this service, something must come out, something must sprout out in Jesus' name. I want you just to meditate upon the goodness of God and just allow the Spirit to be made manifest in this place, in Jesus' name. Shalabada. If you are filled with the Holy Ghost, just speak in tongues. Shakadabada, likuzadai, leduzabadai, kazadabadai, yekuzadabada, zekaluza, kanibazola badazia, kadakai, lekada zadadai, lekuzabadai, karikuzadagazai, kagadazia, laka zaka, come on, increase the intensity, shakadabagai. Spirit Abazia, Balakosa Dagazia, Kane Goza Kanabazai, Lekosa Dakar, Seterebo Sakadai, Lekosa Pragai, Laza Dagazai. The Spirit is in the house. Come on, say, Baba. Conceived by one, even by our father Isaac. For the children being not yet born, neither having done any good or evil, that the purpose of God according to the election might stand, not of works, but of him that calleth. He will say that unto her, the elder shall serve the younger, and it is written, Jacob I love, but Esau have I hated. What shall we send them if is there unrighteousness with God? God forbid. Father, we thank you for your word. Let us obtain power. Let us obtain sweet waters. In Jesus' name, someone say amen. Amen. Come on, say amen for Jesus. Amen. Glory be to God. In the next 40 minutes, I want to share about altars. And I've prepared my sermon. I'll be making an introduction today, and we shall take it to a level higher in our second service, in Jesus' mighty name. Your chair has just introduced me, and I'm glad to be in this place. Praise the living God. Amen. Amen. I want you to know that life is not just the way you are seeing it. Life has propelling faith face, that are the forces that control life. Anything that happens in life, it does not just happen like that, but there are forces that are propelling life to look the way they are. They are propelling forces that determines how life is. Anything that happens in your life, it is as a result of something that is happening behind it. When you see a rat running straight to the fire, it is not that the rat has decided to warm itself, but it is because there is something hotter that is pursuing the rat. Praise the living God. There is a saying that says that a child cannot run in the day. Praise the living God. So when you talk about altars, altars are supernatural system of authorization. Amen. Altars are supernatural system of authorization. And the Bible says that there were two sons, Jacob and Esau. And these two sons, something was determined before they were born. They were born into the world, that decision already made. The system of authorization was in place. Praise the living God. You might be sitting here, you are born into things that you don't understand how they happen in your life. But today I came so that we nullify every arguments and every decisions that were made upon your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Every decision that were made before you are born, today we are canceling them in the name of Jesus. Can you shout a bigger amen for Jesus? You know, things don't just happen. A word is in operation. I call them spiritual influence on the reality of life. Praise the living God. If you see things happening in your life and you wonder how they are happening, there are altars that was raised in your life. Some of them we don't know, some of them we know, but today we are tackling them in the name of Jesus Christ. Can someone say amen for Jesus? Amen. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. And the Bible says that Rebecca decided to do something. And before these children were born, neither having done good or evil. So when you talk about altars, altars is a platform where the realms of the spirit make contact with the physical realm or the legal ground. Amen. The platform where the realm of the spirit makes contact with the physical realm on the legal ground. And man is the only legal entity, or is the ground that has authorization to make contact with the realm of the spirit. Praise the living God. An altar cannot operate without a legal ground or entity. It must find somewhere to operate. Praise the living God. It must have a body where it operates. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Praise the Lord. Every spirit is at the mercy of the body or an altar to find expression in the territory. Amen. The first death in the Bible of Cain and Abel, it occurred on the account of altars. And the Bible says that Cain killed his brother Abel. And when he killed, the Bible says that God appeared to Cain. And he's asking that, where is your brother? And the answer that Cain gave, it qualified God to give the curse to Cain. Praise the living God. If Cain could have answered right with God, a curse would not have come to him. Praise the living God. Glory be to Jesus. If you see things happening the way they're happening, it is because a word was spoken. If you see things going the way they are going, a word was released. Praise the living God. And that word made an altar in your life. And the altar came into existence and it's now operating in your life. Praise the living God. Amen. Now I want you to know this, that people can only be the victim of what you're going through. Amen. Sometimes you look around how things are happening in your life and you begin complaining about people, but people can only be the victim of what is happening in your life. You can have been done 7 miscarriages. The 7th doctor who is helping you to do the miscarriage is only the victim of what is happening in your life. Amen. Some time back, before Corona began last year, there is a man and maintaining it. A covenant cannot walk without an altar. Praise the Lord. Because it is an altar that gives life to a covenant. An altar is just like a bedroom that powers the covenant. Every covenant you make, every covenant you get into, it must have an altar that operates. Praise the living God. The system of authorization works best on the covenant. The more you make covenant with God, the more you raise an altar. Praise the living God. Glory be to Jesus. Now, the Bible says in the book of Mark 7, is it 13 or 12 there? That the children of the world are wiser than the children of the earth. Praise the Lord. Do you know the reason why people of the world have conquered us and they have taken us and they are much cleverer than who we are today? It's because they have understood the system in which an altar operates. And you are sitting there like a believer, you need to know the dynamics and the secret on which the altar operates. Praise the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. Altars are not just made. Altars are activated by words. Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Lift your right hand and say, God. Say, God. Every covenant that were made in my life, in this service, I win in this service. Every word that was spoken upon my destiny, I win in this service. In Jesus' name. Altars can be physical monuments, can be institutions, can be people. The reason why the altar of salvation can work is because an altar was erected through Jesus. That's why the Bible says that whosoever calls on his name shall be saved. It is because Jesus raised an altar and is calling people to his side to come and receive him. Anything that you raise, either good or bad, it attracts a multitude of people towards it. Praise the living God. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Spirit of God. John 36 verse 20. I want to tell you the secret that is behind the altars. John 36 verse 20. The Bible says, that desire not the night when people are cut off in their place. Psalms 19 verse 2. The Bible says that the day uttereth speech, where the night showeth knowledge. Now listen, the day is only the custodian of the night. Whatever is manifested in the day, the decisions were made in the night. operate during the day, they operate during the night, because they understand that the battle does not begin in the day, the battle begins in the night. Praise the Lord. The day will only utter the speech that was made in the night. That's why a witch can take anything from you, and during the night when you sleep, he makes some vows and some word upon you. You wake up during the day and you wonder, what is happening in my life? Because the word was spoken in the night. Have you ever asked yourself, why do you wake up in the morning feeling so tired? Yet you slept so well during the night. You're waking up in the morning, you're feeling so tired. It's like you've been fighting battles in the night. Praise the Lord. Now, morning glory does not begin at 5 in the morning. Morning glory must begin at in the evening at around 5 to 6 then. Praise the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. Praise the Lord. You wake up in the morning and you feel that you are so tired because someone has already taken the position in prayer and he has uttered some words in you. The day will only speak the speech, but the night reveals the knowledge. Can you raise your right hand and say, God, whichever word that was spoken upon me in the night, as I'm listening to this sermon, I utter the speech of deliverance upon my life. Come on, in 1 minute you can tell God that in this day, I deliver myself from every word that was spoken by the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost. You've been delivered from every word that was uttered during the night in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, in Jesus' name. Job 5:12. Shakarabada. Leko Zabadai. What does the Bible say? 1-3. Let's begin from verse 11. To set up on high those that be low, that those which mourn may be exalted to safety. He disappointed the devices of the crafty, so that their hands cannot perform their enterprises. Shada. Lezoda Bakai. Father, we thank you, Lord. There are altars that God is delivering you right now as you're speaking, in the name of Jesus, in the mighty name of Jesus. Now, let me tell you something. You know, by the fact that you are in the university, you can be in the university, you can enter into the gates of university, but the real factor, the real gate is waiting at you at the village. Praise the Lord. The fact that you are in the university does not qualify you to run away from altars. When you look yourself and you look at your family, maybe you are the first one to join the university. I came to understand that when God wants to use a person, there are some battles that he or she must conquer, so that God might show himself upon the life of that person. Praise the living God. When you take your statistics very well, maybe you are the only one who has stepped in this university. Praise the Lord. There is a time I was praying and God revealed to me a revelation, and he took me a step behind, and I was looking at the lineage in my family, and I came to realize that I was the only one who stepped at the door of the university. Praise the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. And God reminded me something, that there are altars that has been operating in your family that I wanted you to conquer in your life. Praise the living God. You need to look at your family and see how things are going in your family. You need to look at your family and see the life of people in your family and say, I'm not for this. I'm not end looking like this, because the Bible says that he has called us for greatness, and the Bible says that he shall lift the lowly into the highest place in the name of Jesus. And in this place I prophesy upon your life that you are going to be lifted in the name of Jesus. Whichever level that your family did not reach, I'm saying that you're going to reach in the mighty name of Jesus. I don't know if I'm speaking to somebody in this place, but I see the altars of your family being broken in the name of Jesus. If I'm speaking to you, resurrect and say that God deliver me from every altar that has been speaking against my family in the name of Jesus. I'm seeing you being exceptional from your family in the name of Jesus. There is a time just last year around August, I had my friend, a very good friend of mine, just comes in Western there. And this man was staying in Nairobi, and he decided to buy a vehicle, a very good vehicle. And one day he decided just to pay the visit back in the village. Now, the reason, by the fact that you are in town, does not make you escape the altars that are in the village. Praise the Lord. Now, this man, when he reached the village, and he really surprised a lot of people, the village. Now, when his father saw him, he called him and told him, "Son, come, I want to tell you something." The father had a Peugeot 504, the old vehicle, and it was just then the compound. And he told him, "Son, I want you to do this, and I want you to be very careful. When you go back the town in Nairobi, please sell this car. I'm not permitted to tell you this. If your mother could have been alive, he could have told you this. When you go back, please sell the car." The man went back and he didn't sell the car. After 1 month, the wife died. And he was like, "What is happening in my life?" He carried the body of his wife. He went into the village to bury the wife. Now, when he was in the village again, the father called him and told him, "Son, I warned you and I told you, go and sell this car. You are allowed to have a vehicle, but let it be a little bit lower than mine." Those are the words of the father. The man went back. He didn't hear what the father said. This man was born into vows that in the family, people are not supposed to drive a car. I don't know whom I'm speaking to in this meeting, but I'm seeing you, that God is lifting you to levels in the mighty name of Jesus. There are levels that you are born into vows. I want you to know that people are born into vows. Altars are made because of the vows. And God is calling us and saying that he shall lift us into the level. Praise the living God. Amen. It was in the life of Jacob. The Bible says that Jacob took the birthright. And when Esau came from the field, and he approached the father, and he was crying in need 7 times, and he told the father that, "Where is my blessing?" The father said that there is nothing left for you. And the father said that the time you get restless, that is Genesis 27 verse 40, you shall break the yoke of your brother out of your neck. The time you get restless, you need to reach a point whereby you are so restless with what is happening in your life. You need to get a point that you become so restless. You need to come to a point and see how your sisters are ending in your family. You need to get to a point and see how things are going in your family, and you say that, "I'm not for this." The Bible says that it reached a point where Esau decided to go and meet Jacob, and the Bible says that when Jacob saw him, he sent some of the servants, and the Bible says when Esau saw them, he told them that, "I have noticed the secret. I don't want I don't want the blessing from my brother, but I've decided to break the yoke out of my life. Listen to me, child of God. You need to reach a point whereby you get restless. The moment you get restless, you will break the yoke out of your neck in the name of Jesus Christ. Lift your right hand and tell God, I break loose, I break loose, I break loose from every altar in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of God. Thank you, Spirit of God. We give you glory. Now, altars, people are born into vows. That is number one. Number two, people are born already given to unseen. Given to unseen. Your father used to speak to you while you're still here. Whatever they spoke unto you, it might be something that is still disturbing your life unto this point. But the fact that your father and your mother gave birth to you does not qualify for the blessing from them. Praise the living God. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Number three, people are born into some invisible dons. People are born into some invisible dons. Amen. There are people here. There are some things that when they try laying their hands, it cannot work. Praise the Lord. There are some people, even if I take them here and I take them to the state house and I call all the executive together with the president and I tell them, the entire executive that now, this is now your congregation. At the end of the day, you are only connected and you are in the state house. Praise the living God. The highest amount of offering can collect is temple. Now, state house is not a problem. Praise the Lord. State house is not a problem. Right now, when I take you to the central bank and I take you to the storehouse of money, and I tell you now, begin collecting money. And at the end of the day, you come out with nothing. It is enough to tell you that there is something controlling you. Praise the Lord. How can you miss collecting money in the central bank? Praise the Lord. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. So people are born into some invisible dons. Glory to God. Invisible dons. Amen. Number four, people are naturally born with some blessings. People are naturally born with some blessings. 1 Samuel chapter 1 from 9 to 10 to 11. Now, there is a woman called Anna who understood this. And the Bible says that before Samuel was born, Hannah had a desire to have a child, but God wanted a prophet. And he reminded God and told God that, you know what, give me a child and I'll give you a prophet. And the Bible says that Anna, before Samuel was born, no rays of light will pass through Samuel. And the blessings of God followed Samuel. You look at Samuel and you see the prophet in him. You look at Samuel and you see the kingdom service into his life. Praise the living God. Now I want you to know this morning that one of the natural way of establishing an altar is consistency. That is the way in which altars are established. Altars are not made in one day. The consistency of it, the consistency of the practice within a ritual attracts the realm of the spirit. Praise the Lord. The Bible talks of a man called Jacob. And Jacob, the Bible says that he was sitting somewhere under the tree, and he fell asleep, and he was conversing with the angels. And when he woke up, he said that I've noticed something that was not in this place. Praise the Lord. Now, if people at that time could pass that place where Jacob had had a conversation with the Spirit, the sickness could have just been solved. Praise the Lord. Because we had been a place, but because of the consistency in that place, it attracts the realm of the Spirit. Praise the living God. Now, in a university setup like this, you can be wondering why are things happening. There is a lot of immorality. It is not because you came with the immorality here, but the consistency of the people that were in that place attracted immorality in that place. Praise the Lord. That's why you come and you enter into the system. Praise the Lord. It is not that you left the seminary school with the immorality, but because of the environment and the consistency attracted the realm of the Spirit, you came and you went into through it. Praise the living God. And even some of you cannot even understand why is it happening like this. Praise the Lord. It is good to find the roots, not the signs. Amen. Now I want you to know that not all altars were consciously built, if you're writing. Altars are not necessarily traceable, but things you constantly do build altars and eventually becomes invitations of the Spirit. Amen. Glory to God. Now, when you consistently raise an altar of prayer, praise the Lord, that altar is built up, and eventually it begins to attract the realm of the Spirit. Glory be to Jesus. An intercessor, we need to reach at a point, because the beauty of prayer is not just for you continuing talking for the rest of your life. Praise the Lord. But the altar that you have raised, it attracts the realms of the Spirit. Glory be to God. We need to reach a point whereby even in our silence, some things have been solved in the realm of the Spirit. Praise the living God. As a living altar, you need to attract possibility even as you walk. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. Amen. You need to do what? To activate possibilities even as you walk. That is the beauty of prayer. And that can only happen when you raise an altar of prayer. Amen. There are things that can't be solved just because you have raised an altar of prayer. Amen. You can be here, but things have been so packed in your village. You can be here, but things are working and things are being opened in the realm of the Spirit just because you have activated possibility by the power of the altar. The consistency in the altar activates possibilities even as you walk. And that is the level that I came to raise some of you here in the name of Jesus. Because you have prayed and nothing is happening in Jesus' mighty name. But as you continue praying like that, I see you raising an altar in the mighty name of Jesus. And that altar of consistency is even able to help you to solve what you are going through in the name of Jesus. There are some altars that are being sold just because you have footed yourself in prayers. In the mighty name of Jesus, come and say a great amen for Jesus. Because as a Christian, there are not only things you'll be sold in prayer. God is raising ministers in this place. By the fact that you have invested so much in prayer, there are things that will be tackled just because of your presence. There are things your atmosphere will destroy the altar that are in that particular place in Jesus' mighty name. I don't know whom I'm talking to, but God is locating you right now in Jesus' mighty name. In the name of Jesus Christ. Glory be to Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Lift your right hand. The Spirit of God is in this place. I don't want to go deeper. We shall leave side in our second service. But I want to do something because I know some of you are going to be here. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we thank you. Colossians 2:14. Colossians 2:14.
Jesus' name. Now, some of you here, I'm
I'm seeing your image somewhere. And that image, they normally take your image and look at it in the mirror. But on the other hand, I'm seeing the image of Christ manifesting in your image. Manifesting in your image. They took it and they said that you're not going far. Today I came to push you in the name of Jesus. To push you in the name of Jesus. Spirit of God, continue locating them. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Ulichukuliwa na ukawekwa kwa madhabahu ya wachawi. I don't know witchcraft, but I know Godcraft. God is locating you and is delivering you right now. Right now. The power of the Holy Ghost is removing you from every altar that was broken against you. In the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit of God, locate them in Jesus' name. I want you to stand up on your feet. And I want us to break those altars together. To break those altars together. There are people here, God is raising them. You have been having so much difficulties, even in your studies. In your first year, second year, third year, it has not just been an easy task for you. But God is pushing you to your destiny. In the name of Jesus, raise your hand. I'm seeing you finishing swiftly your academics in the name of Jesus. The altars of your parents will not follow you. In the mighty name of Jesus. And if you're the one I'm speaking to, I want just to come forward here. In the mighty name of Jesus. Don't walk around here. In Jesus' name. We have the serious matters here. Lakasa. Lekosakata. Leposakata. I want you to come in front here. In Jesus' mighty name. I want this place to be occupied. Lavasa. Lekosakata. Don't walk around in front here. Lekosakata. Lepakasata. In the mighty name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, the praise and worship us, you can come. Let us, in the mighty name of Jesus, the Spirit of God is in this place. The Spirit of God is in this place. Others have been broken. Others have been destroyed. La ba ba ba. Leko sakata. Prasata ba. It is fire for fire. Leko sabada. In the mighty name of Jesus. Leba sa. Leko sakata. In Jesus' mighty name. Now raise your hands.
Spirit of love, Jesus.
Just allow them to come here.
Continue praying
the Spirit. Continue praying. There is power in the house. There is power in the house.
Thank you.
The Spirit of God is locating you wherever you are. Wherever you are. There are 50 people in this place. And the Spirit is telling me, God is opening doors for them. God is opening doors for them. The moment you leave this university, you are not going to tamper for joy. You are not going to tamper for joy. The Spirit is locating you right now in the name of Jesus. The battles of your family are destroyed. They say that you don't receive it, but you are receiving it. Open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors, open doors. Rakasa, Yakata. Continue praying, continue praying. Rakasa, Lekasa, Lekosa, Yaka, Yakata. And you wonder how it is happening in your life.
Caleb, John, Erastus, Erastus, Labazadaka, James. Are those names here? Are those names here? Also, I'm seeing Esther, Lakazada, and Mary. Lebozadaka. Where are those people? Lebozadaka. In the name of Jesus. Thank you, Spirit of God. We love you, God. Thank you, Lord. Raise your hands. I don't want to go deeper. Those who come in the second service, we shall be doing much more than this. So purpose to be here on the second service. There are a lot of things the Spirit is revealing to me, but because of time, I'll not do now. But the second service, we shall do something in the name of Jesus. The Spirit wants to impart some people here with a gift. I'm seeing greater destinies in this place. God is releasing destiny. I'm seeing Joshua generation in this place. God is raising them. In this particular place. I'm seeing you as a victor. I'm seeing you as a conqueror. In the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Father, we glorify your name. We give you glory, we give you honor, in Jesus' name.
Amen.